Welcome back to another episode of Blue LED Lights. No, thank you. I just ate. And today we are reacting to the new Luke Hemmings EP titled Boy. And I am very excited for this one because Luke's 2021 album, When Facing the Things We Turn Away From, was and still is my favorite album of that year. And so I am very eager to see the direction this one is going in. I did listen to the two singles in the lead up to this album, the first one being Shakes, which I really liked, and the second one being Close My Eyes, which I liked a little bit less, but I still enjoyed. I will, of course, be re-reacting to them in the context of the EP and addressing if my feelings have changed or not. I'm fully expecting this to be a totally blissful, dreamy pop experience. This EP does have very big shoes to fill, and while I'm not expecting something as expansive as the debut, I do have somewhat high expectations going into this. So with all that being said, we are going to start with the first track titled I'm Still Your Boy.
Sat in the driveway, and I can't go in. Can I be your friend?
Okay, so he seems to be setting up some themes here about wanting to return to his youth, which makes sense given the title of the EP.
Things that I missed, can't
kill. The strings. Sounds so sweet. Vocals? So he's repeating, I'm still your boy. I guess he's maybe talking to his mother? This is actually really cute and touching. I mean, the more I'm sitting here and digesting it, the more it's kind of reducing me to a child. Wow. Damn, I feel like I need to call my mom after that. I'm really feeling the emotion coming through in that one. Man, Luke is just like not wasting any time to like hit you with some emotion here. The way he kept repeating, I want it so bad, the yearning for the childhood, that's really, I don't know, that was just really well done. I'm with him on that. I'm feeling it. All right, next one, we got a total banger. It's Shakes, the first single, and one I've listened to a lot, so let's vibe out.
Lost in the morning, time starts to crawl.
Perfect choice of tone and instruments, like everything going on here. The synths, the soft drums, the perfect amount of reverb on his voice. Everything's coming together perfectly on this song. Very catchy, sweet chorus. Simple, yes, but memorable. I like that he's doing this thing where, I mean, he's done it a couple times on the previous album. Actually, he does it on the 5 seconds of summer song, Teeth, where he's like, call me in the morning to apologize. Every little lie gives me butterflies. Like, the way he's ending it, like, not completely resolving the chord, like, leaving that tension there. He's kind of doing it on this chorus here where he's like, can't shake this feeling. Like, it's kind of leaving you hanging a little bit, and I really like that. It doesn't end, like, entirely predictably. This bass coming in. I think that song works really well after the first track where he's talking about wanting to return to his childhood, and he's saying in this song he can't shake the feelings that he's having that are coming flooding back by wishing he was a child again. He's stressed out by his current life. So yeah, I still really like that song. I do think it's maybe a little bit watered down from something on his debut album. It feels just feels like a slightly more formulaic version of something from the debut, but it's still a great song. I think the vibes are still there, definitely. All right, track number 3 is called Benny. Manny in the Jets.
Watching from the outside.
Oh.
Should I be on a plane back home? Sentimental landslide.
Okay, before we get to this chorus, yeah, these drums sound great. They're nice and punchy. I'm loving the dun 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 dun. I don't exactly know the melody of the bass line, but it's super funky. Yeah, I'm loving this so far. Not a bad chorus. I'm weirdly liking the verses a little bit more, the groove of it. It's a little bit lost in the chorus. It's pretty much a love song. It's reminding me a little bit of Adore You by Harry Styles. I will say it is getting a little bit lost in the production sauce here. It feels like it's being a little bit drowned out by, like, I think those highs in the mix are mainly coming from the ride cymbal. Loved in the outro where they stripped out most of the instruments there and showed you the bones a little bit. Yeah, I mean, that was probably my least favorite so far, just because there wasn't a whole lot to that song. Like, the songs on the debut album felt a lot larger, a lot more expansive. Again, I really liked the groove on the verses there, but I wasn't completely sold on the chorus. Next up, we got the other single that I heard called Close My Eyes. I've only listened to this one a handful of times, so let's see how it sounds in the context of the album. I'm seeing that the song starts with the line, "Don't be sad," in the middle, and we're at the middle of the album, which, very clever. Oh yeah, these drums. I'm a drummer, so I'm always gonna compliment the drums. Don't know about the synth they're choosing here on this pre-chorus. Feels a little out of place. This is a good chorus. I'm suddenly loving this one a lot more. Woo! These syncopated drums now at the end. Yeah, dude. I'm loving the emphasis on drums on this EP, especially because that was a highlight of certain tracks off the debut album, such as Starting Line. This was a perfectly placed song. This kept the momentum going. I actually really like this in context of the album. It's making me like the song a lot more than when I did when I listened to it on its own. And similar to the song Starting Line, this song seems to be about sort of fleeting moments in life, whether that comes with regret or wanting to have those moments back. Yeah, absolute banger, that one. Only three left. Damn, I wish this was an album. I'm having a fun time listening. All right, this next one is called Garden Life. Very intriguing title. Also, I think this EP is moving fast because the songs are uncharacteristically short for Luke Hemmings. Ooh. Loving the bass line here.
I know.
Oh my god, this is so sweet, dude. So well produced. Love the quaint little instrumentation, and these drums are just so tight. Loving the lyrics on the chorus where he says, "I feel most alive staring out your window. It's a garden life. You are the weeping willow, and I am alcohol swimming through your system, lulling you to sleep. On and on we dream. What comes after me?" Actually, that doesn't really make sense in hindsight. If the person he's talking about is the weeping willow, does that mean the tree drank alcohol? How did they get alcohol swimming through their system? I know he's doing two different I still like those lyrics, but having those come after one another is weird. Okay.
I feel most alive.
This is a very nocturnal album I'm gathering. Okay, kind of had a similar ending to other songs on the album where you have that repeated line and he's interjecting previous lines in between them. So it's feeling a little bit formulaic, especially in terms of structure here. This definitely isn't the scope of the debut album. It's not blowing me away in the same way, but it is still a quality listen. I do wish these song lengths were longer because I feel like they could be built up a little bit more. I mean, that's sort of my high expectations talking here, but still. All right, this next one is called Close Enough to Feel You. I wanna be the last dream inside your head. Gotta be honest, I usually like Luke's falsetto, but it feels a little bit heavy-handed in this chorus. Also, it's feeling really formulaic at this point. This feels a little bit uninspired, if I'm being honest. Okay, drums. See, when in doubt, the drums never fail me. This verse sounds pretty with that guitar in the background. Ooh. I feel like there were probably more interesting ways to write a song like this. He's essentially just saying, I want to be close enough to feel you, but the pain's familiar. I'm falling apart again. I'm falling apart again. It's a little bit cliched. Okay, yeah, I mean, the sound of that was still sweet. It still sounded good. I do think it's the weakest of the tracks so far. I think it was the least interesting instrumentally and lyrically, but not a bad song by any means. All right, we're at the last song already. It's called Promises. And this one is 4.5 minutes, so let's send it home, Luke. I know if I was in my bag, this would be wrecking me right now, probably. Does sound so sweet, though. Yeah, that was sweet. I liked that. For me, it's not living up to the album, which it doesn't have to, but this batch of songs ultimately feels a little bit more inconsequential. Obviously, the sound of it is very sweet, and they clearly spent a lot of time making it sound pretty, but it's not blowing me away like any of the songs on the debut album did. I think my favorites were I'm Still Your Boy, Shakes, Close My Eyes, and Garden Life. I think I'm feeling a 74 currently on this EP. All right, that's gonna do it for me. If you guys enjoyed the video, please leave a like. If you wanna donate to the channel, which is literally the only way I make any sort of money off of this channel, off of all the hours that I put into editing and filming and whatnot, that link will be in the description as well. Don't feel like you have to, but if you do, I will reply to you and I will be eternally grateful. But once again, thank you guys for watching and I will see you in the next one. Peace out.